if something hits on TikTok, it hits really well. The algorithm is much more preferable, in my opinion, than it is on like Instagram.
Oh, Instagram's on the out. Instagram is, I barely even post on Instagram anymore because it's just so not worth it. I don't know what's going on with the Instagram algorithm.
Yeah, Reels was bad. I don't know what that was all about. But okay, so tell us about your experience as a cosplayer on TikTok, and also can you tell me a little bit about Instagram, because you also do have a sizable following on IG.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I mean, TikTok. We got into TikTok. I called Ren, and I was like, it was literally like, what, do you remember when it was still super cringy? Like it was like embarrassing. Like people still called it like Musically. I had a friend that like got like famous on TikTok before it was like still in the hit or miss era. I called Ren. I was like, I think we need to get on this. I was like, we can't tell anybody. It's so embarrassing, but we should get on this app. So we got on it like right before everybody else did, like when it was still super, super, super cringy. TikTok was insane. We were getting like 10,000 followers a day. I don't post as much on TikTok anymore just because like real life stuff. I have just so much stuff going on with like my actual film career. And a lot of the time I kind of like rather focus on YouTube if I'm going to have a priority with any of them. But yeah, that's kind of how I did TikTok. Instagram, yeah, I do my photos. I don't post as much there anymore just because the outreach is so bad. I just feel like every update Instagram makes is for the worse. Like the shopping thing, the reels. And I just like don't get that much enjoyment out of like posting on there anymore. But like I'll still post occasionally.
At what point did you start to see this change on Instagram affecting your numbers and your outreach? A lot of content creators have told me the same, that when they started seeing more updates coming to IG and they started seeing more ads and like, you know, buy this, shop here, that all of a sudden their cosplay photos and their sets, it started to dip down.
So pretty much it happened like 2016 is when I feel like the algorithm first got bad, or like 2017, like when I started in college. It was really, really bad. And the only reason, that was part of the reason me and Bren started TikTok, was because I had probably 50,000 followers, maybe even less. I think I had like 20,000 or something, 20, 40. Now I have like 100, you know, over 100K. But they all came in through TikTok. Nothing was from the actual Instagram algorithm.
Really?
Yeah. So it used to be pretty much if you had moved to TikTok, you were getting new followers. But if you hadn't moved to TikTok, and I think, you know, that's a pretty bad way to run your site. And now they're trying to be TikTok. As soon as a new thing comes that's going to be able to share photos, like I can't see Instagram being able to continue because it just because they could have listened to people that are like, hey, we want a better algorithm. We want the post to show up in order. I don't even see my friends' posts sometimes. Like, it doesn't even show up on my feed. We want, like, better outreach. Instead, Instagram added the shopping thing. He's trying to promo reels that nobody uses. And then there's the whole thing with, I heard, like, if there's a TikTok logo, like, the reels don't do as well. Because they're trying to, like, get people to make their original reels, but nobody's going to do that because TikTok already exists. I think they're trying to do what they did with Snapchat where they just stole the thing and it went well, but it's just like no one's gonna do that with Instagram. And I just see it getting worse and worse and worse and worse. I'm already seeing like less and less people posting on Instagram. I think as soon as something else comes along that can replace it, wow, it's gonna get replaced.
Wow, that's really interesting. Thank you for sharing that, because I always wonder what someone's experiences are like when it comes to reaching a certain level for content creation, and then when they start navigating to a different platform and they start seeing their numbers increase there as well. It's like, I understand if you have a team, you can focus on 5 or 6 different platforms, but when you're a smaller creator and you have like an in real life thing to worry about, you know, like a life outside of the internet, some people have it, all of a sudden it's kind of difficult to focus on something that you're not getting the reception that you once were getting, or you're not getting as much of a reception that you should be. I really care about getting my content out to as many people as possible. So when I collaborate with other channels, channels, I usually help out with the marketing and the SEO stuff. But like you said, I noticed myself around 2018, but that's probably just because of the niche that I was creating in. Around 2018, TikTok wasn't hitting at the time, but it was still a thing, like 2018 to 2019, musically at TikTok. But
yeah,
Instagram,
that's like right when we got in, yeah.
That was a good time to get in because Instagram, I noticed it like flatlined. It flatlined and it was really weird because I have a friend who was doing so much content and so much collaboration and his account never grew past 250,000. It actually went down. I think he's sitting at just over 200K and it's like he is active, but even his most diehard fans say things like, we don't see your content. He'll put up a story saying, hey guys, have you seen this? And he'll show a post from like 3 days ago and people will be like, we didn't see that at all.
Yeah, no, it's the Insta. I don't know why they, instead of like listening to what people, and it's been going on for like years now, instead of listening to people. And the other issues, there's no incentive for creators to keep making stuff because YouTube, like I've been able to have a career on YouTube. Like I haven't had to worry about money because through sponsorships and opportunities I've gotten through YouTube and its monetization method, you know, like that. It totally pays off. And even TikTok now has the creator fund. There's like sponsorship opportunities. And there are sponsorships on Instagram, but you know, like it's just not, there's no like, there's not really a monetary payoff unless somehow somebody's paying you for like story posts. But like to have that kind of engagement that they would do that. Instagram. That's my vote.
They're digging their own grave.
Yeah, I mean, that really is the thing. It's like, if they just listen, they could, but it's just they keep trying to go in the wrong direction, which are the reels. Because it's like, you're not going to be TikTok. Focus on the photos. That's the one thing you have right now. The second somebody has something with photos, you're done.
And I think that's coming soon. I don't know what platform. I don't know if it's going to be an extension of something that already exists or not. But I can't realistically see Instagram being the site for someone to invest a lot of time and just effort into come 2022. I just don't see it.
And like, it's impossible if like you're new Instagram to like get off the ground and stuff too. Cause like there's no discovery, there's no reach or anything. Yeah, my theory is if TikTok makes something where you can have like a photo section,
it's a wrap.
That'd be the final. But, you know, Snapchat's still kicking, so.
Yeah, I've always used Snapchat. For a while, I was using it only as, like, a messaging tool. But then I started, like, looking at the changes they made. I like the layout. They've really put a lot of effort into trying to resurrect it, and good for them.
If Snapchat ever goes away, I'm going to be devastated because I don't have, like, enough phone space. So I keep all my photos and memories. So I'm going to lose, like, 4 years of, like, photos if Snapchat goes away.
Oh my gosh, that's big brain right there. Why pay for iCloud?
Right? I literally just use it on Snapchat.
That's funny.